Good morning, children. As you can see the topic which I have already written. So today's topic is some important adjectives and terminals for various competitive exams like Indian and others. So today we will be focusing on some very fundamental adjectives and terminals which quite often confuse students. And students get confused because of the very basic idea, which is very simple, and at times it is confusing, but if we see it in a proper way, so we will see that there is no room for the confusion, for getting confused. So before I take up this things, today's terms, I would say, you know, that long back this adjective and determiners, they are similar in many ways as well as they are different. Some 20 years back or in the olden time, you know, there were no determinants. And today, whatever the determinants we study, actually they were taught into the chapter adjective. But recently, in the recent past, what they have done, some of the grammarians, they have taken out some of the adjectives and they have made a separate chapter called determinants. Determinants, you know, they qualify noun and pronoun. And determiners, adjective qualify noun and pronoun. And adjective may appear before noun or they may also come after noun. But determiners, they never qualify noun and pronoun. They specify, they limit the meaning of noun. And determiners always appear before noun. So into this, in today's video, I will teach you certain determiners, or you may say adjectives, which are really, at times it is confusing. So first is further or farther and furthest. See, in the root we need to understand these, whether we call it further or farther or furthest or farthest. This is comparative degree and this is superlative degree. And what is the positive degree? Positive degree will be far. So they are what? They are adjective in the three degrees. So first we have learned that further and farther are comparative degree, and furthest and farthest are superlative degree. So now here we need to understand one thing, that whether we call further or further or farther or furthest and farthest, this all can be used for place, for the distance. Further and farther can both be used as for distance, and these two can again be used for distance. How? Let us see example. New York is, here you may say further and farther both, than London. See, here we have been further or farther. Both we can write, and this would mean for distance. Similarly, New York is furthest or farthest of all the three cities. So here again we have written furthest and farthest. So here these both the sentences, they mean about distance. These are in imperative form, these are in superlative form. But next, that is further and farthest. They are used for, they mean next or additional. How? No further discussion is required in this matter. So here it will be only further. Here we cannot write further. They had reached to the furthest of discussion in this matter. So here again we can write, we will only write for this. So is that clear, children? See, once again let us understand. Further or farther, they are comparative degree of far, and furthest and farthest, they are the superlative degree. Now these four things, further or farther, or further and farther, both can be used, all these four can be used for distance. These two, both could mean for distance in comparative degree, and this both could mean for distance in superlative degree. How? See, we have done an example. Need of is further or farther. Since we are talking about distance and it's in comparison, we are doing comparison of New York and London. So here we can use both further and farther. Here New York is furthest or farthest of all the three cities. Here we are again talking in distance, but it's in superlative form because we have taken more than three cities under consideration. So again here we can use any further or furthest or farthest. But this further F-U-R-T-H-E-R and furthest F-U-R-T-H-E-S-T, furthest, these two would mean only and only next or additional. Here we cannot use that further F-A-R-T-H-E-R. Here these two are only used. No further discussion. Here we can never write farther. Here we will write only further. No further discussion is required in this matter. And they had reached to the furthest of discussion in this matter. Hence, my children, I think these four terms are very much clear to you now. And now I think you will not get confused anymore when you have to use, whenever you find all these things. I think very confidently you can make use of all these four different terms. Now I will pick another group of adjectives or determiners, which you know at times, again that is very confusing. That is older, elder, oldest, eldest. Again these are what? These are comparative form and these are superlative form. What is that positive form? Positive form is old. So we get the degree of adjectives in this form: old, older, elder, oldest and eldest. Now we need to understand where do we use older and oldest and where do we use elder and eldest. So now I tell you one thing, that this elder and eldest, we use only in terms of family members. People of family members. People of family members. This elder and eldest are used only for people of family members. One more thing you need to here understand, that more, I am writing with more, that with elder we never use than, it is wrong. So with tender we have to use 2. You have to also keep in mind. And next, this older and oldest. This could mean people, about people could be used for people going outside the family members, and can also mean about things and objects. Once again, you try to understand. This older and elder is the comparative form of old, and this oldest and eldest is the superlative form of old. So where do we use elder and eldest? We use elder and eldest when we talk about the people of family members. One more thing I said about elder is that with elder we never use than. We elder we always use two. And where do we use older and eldest? Oldest, we use older and oldest when we talk about people going outside the family member, general people, and things or objects. Now let us see through certain examples. Whatever I have said, you will see these things with some examples for your easy understanding. My grandfather is the eldest member in the family. I told you that we use elder and eldest in the family members. So my grandfather is the eldest member in the family. Here you can never use oldest. My brother is elder to me. Here I cannot write than because I told you with elder we don't write than, we write to. So this was the use of elder, eldest, and elder talking about the members of family. Now let us talk about the older and oldest. Older and oldest could mean like Mr. Sharma is the oldest member in our village community. So Mr. Sharma we have written in terms of age, he is the eldest, but then see in the one family, in a village community, there are so many members and they don't have to do anything with the family members, that's why I have written oldest. And oldest can also mean for also objects like Qutub Minar is older in construction than the Red Fort. So here there are objects, two objects we are comparing, and that's why I have them older. I cannot use elder. So is that clear? Older and oldest could mean about people who are not our family members, and they could also mean about objects. And elder and eldest are exclusively used for the family members. So now all these things are clear. Now I would take a group of other few confusing, you know, determiners or adjectives. And this I would take together. That I would take little. And few, a few, and the few. You know, people and students get confused about the use of all these words. So first, how you can divide them, separate them, This is of where these little oligodial, this all belong to one particular group and category, and they are understood in one way, and the other is few, offshoot and offshoot. They are grouped together in a separate group and they are studied separately. So first, the thing which distinguish them is that little oligodial, is for uncountable. And few of you know is used for countable. This is the first difference. Now let us see the meaning of little. Little means hardly any. Hardly any. And the meaning is negative. Meaning is in negative. So the meaning of little is hardly any, and the meaning is in negative. If I say I have little money, that means I have almost no money. The value is in negative, it's zero. Now the meaning of a little. A little means some, though not much. Here the meaning comes in, you know, positive, something, you know, the meaning, we get to see the meaning in positive. But again, nemo means, you know, much. So it means some, though not much. In that case, I would say, I have a little money, means yes, I have some money. And the meaning of the little, you know, it means not much, but all that is. What is the meaning of this? The little means not much, but all that is. That is, I have spent the little money I have. That means मेरे पास जितने बहुत ही थोड़े बहुत पैसे थे मैंने सब खर्च कर दिए. मतलब अगर मेरे पास 100 रुपीज था तो उस 100 रुपीज में से 100 का 100 खर्च हो गया, उसमें से 1 रुपया भी नहीं बचा. अगर मेरे पास 50 रुपीज था तो 50 का 50 खर्च हो गया, उसमें से 1 रुपया वापस नहीं बचा. Is that clear? Once again, I revise, I do the, make you think, make you understand the things once again. So the basic difference between little, a little, the little, and few, a few, the few is little, a little, the little is used for uncountable. The meaning of little is hardly any. Meaning is in negative. Its meaning negative mein hota hai. Like if I say I have little money, that means the balance is in negative. If I say the meaning of a little is some, though not much, थोड़ा बहुत होता, बहुत ज़्यादा नहीं, और इसका मतलब positive होता है, yes. That means I have a little money, means yes, I have some positive amount. And the little का मतलब होता है not much, बहुत ज़्यादा तो नहीं, but all that is, बहुत ज़्यादा तो नहीं, but जितना भी होता है उन सभी को हम consideration में लेते हैं. Like I have spent the little money I had. कहने का मतलब अगर मेरे पास 100 रुपए थे तो 100 रुपए का मैंने 100 रुपए का 100 रुपए ही खर्च कर दिया, और उसमें से I am not left even with 1 रुपए, उसमें से 1 रुपया भी एक्स्ट्रा मेरे पास नहीं बचा. Same meaning of few, of you, the few is used as we have seen in case of. So few is very much similar to meaning with little. Only difference is few is for countable, little is for uncountable. A few is very similar in meaning with a little. Only difference is few used for countable, a little is used for uncountable. And the same thing, the few is again very similar in meaning with the little. The only difference is the few used for countable and the little is used for uncountable. Let us see the meaning of few. Again, the meaning of few is hardly any. And its meaning is in negative. If I say, I have few story books. Means I have no story books. Value is negative. Number is in negative. Meaning of how few means yes. Some, but not many, and value is in positive. If I say I have a story, I have a few story books, that means yes, I have no 2, 3, 4, 5, that very few, limited, and the few means again. Not many, but all there are. The few का मतलब हो जाएगा बहुत ज़्यादा तो नहीं, but जितने भी हैं, वो सभी को हमें concentration में लेना पड़ेगा. For example, the few story books I have are all of foreign writers. मतलब अगर मेरे पास 20 story books हैं, वो 20 के 20 जो हैं सभी foreign writers के हैं. अगर मेरे पास 40 story books हैं, तो सभी के सभी foreign writers के हैं. उन 40 में से एक भी जो है Indian writers के नहीं है. So this was the meaning. Is that clear? That's very easy in meaning. There is no room for getting confused. Once again, I revise the things for you children. The basic difference first in this group of little, a little, the little, and few, a few, the few is that little, a little, the little is used for uncountable, and few, a few, the few is for countable. The meaning of little is almost nothing, hardly any. Its value is negative in uncountable. Same few meaning is also hardly any, negative is for countable. A little means some, not much. The value is positive and is used for the uncountable. And a few is not many. The value is positive and is used for countable. And the meaning of the little means not much, but all there is we need to consider in case of uncountable. And the few is once again not many, but all there is available we need to consider, and that's in case of, that is your countable. So these were very few, very simple. I don't say these are very tough and very. These are very simple basic things, and adjective and some of the adjective and verbs that will that will give you confidence when you use them and speak them. And tomorrow I will come out with some more of adjectives and determiners in my video, and then we will go for the error, spotting error, because now I have decided that I will take the things that will help you for the various competitive exams. Particularly, I would keep the things NDA in my mind, and I will come out with my videos which will make you, give you a solid preparations for the written exam of NDA exams. Thank you children, and God bless you.